Elijah?
Yes, sir.
You want some Copenhagen?
Fuck no. I like you Longhorn. Real American shit.
What the fuck's that about?
What the fuck's that about? Well, first off, don't you think we need to do our introduction?
I guess we'll get back to that then. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Talon. This is Eli. And you're watching fucking Drop Shit Life. Life.
The only life.
That was a little fucked up. Let me fix the camera. Okay. What are we doing today?
Okay, so we tried this yesterday. We epically failed, but we're doing it again. We had a little rant session going on about Copenhagen and all U.S. smokeless tobacco companies to get products. And I switched from any of their products to Longhorn, one of the cheapest and best tasting chews. Now we actually have two videos we are going to put up. We got this one where we're going to rant, and then we got another video about a new flavor.
What? A new flavor?
A new flavor.
What kind of flavor?
The kind of flavor that's flavored.
Woo!
We'll find out next video. Anyways, let's get on top of this. I'm in a little bit of a better mood today, so maybe this video there won't be a lot of cussing, but who fucking knows? I don't fucking know. Do you fucking know? I don't know.
I don't fucking know.
Fuck right.
Dude, fuck brothers.
Fuck brothers. Yeah. That sounds weird. Anyway, so you want to start off the rant?
So kind of go back to the video we made yesterday.
Yeah.
We made this video kind of like this yesterday, but it fucked up and it wouldn't want to upload, so we're going to redo it now. We were talking about U.S. Smokeless Tobacco Company. Oh, we're going to pack some long whore.
It's actually not bad. It kind of tastes like Copenhagen. But American Copenhagen.
Alright, well, you feel alone while I feel my life.
So, we were running our mouths yesterday about people that run their mouths. U.S. Smokeless has been giving a lot of dip tubers trouble, and they've been telling them to take off videos. They've been deleting videos from other YouTubers' channels because it has their products in it, a.k.a. Copenhagen Skull, Red Seal, Rooster. Rooster is not available anymore, but there's a bunch of other brands. Any brand that's by U.S. Smokeless. So I have volunteered to boycott U.S. Smokeless along with a couple others. Dippers, and I am chewing Longhorn now. It's one of the best low-budget dips. But in my opinion, I think that U.S. Smokeless is fucking up big time because we, us dip tubers, were giving them free street cred. We were coming on our channel and saying, hey, we like this. If you guys want to try it, then you can try it. Now, I know that there's not supposed to be advertisements for dip or cigarettes or any tobacco product at all, because there's an act against it from way back when. But we aren't promoting dip. We are dipping. You choose to do it. We do it. That's as simple as it is. So if you guys choose to go and buy you a can of Longhorn, by fucking God, go fucking do it.
Yeah.
If you choose to go buy you a can of Copenhagen, that's on you. That's not on me. Copenhagen wants to throw a fit about it. U.S. Smokeless wants to throw a fit about it. I am switching to Longhorn, and I'm going to give them as much credit that I can.
Get it? Can? Just can't dip. Okay. Well, my everyday dip for a long time has been Copenhagen Wintergreen. Yeah, there was a few times where I'd switch it up, maybe get something different, or get stuck chewing something different. But with YouTube sending emails in to DipTubers, which is, you know, dip reviewers on YouTube, whatever, sending them emails and taking down their videos about, let's see, where's that? If you can read that, U.S. Smokeless Tobacco Company, for pretty much advertising their products, like we would say, hey, you know, pick you up some of this. Videos like that are getting taken down from, you know, you U.S. Smokeless complaining to YouTube telling you, hey, we found this video, we don't want this here, so delete it. Now, if I was them, I'd be like, oh yeah, people are promoting my product, telling other people to get this. That's going to get me more business. It makes no fucking sense. I might still chew Copenhagen Wintergreen, you know, keep on chewing it, but if we end up getting an email about this shit and a video taken down, I'm done you know, with U.S. Smokeless products on this channel. I'm not going to risk it, losing, you know, you guys and all that shit.
Everyone knows that my favorite dips are Copenhagen, and mostly Copenhagen Black, Skull. I love all Skull. And now I have found Longhorn. I didn't really care for Longhorn in the beginning, but it was because I seen the price tag on it. I didn't think of the quality of such a of a cheaper dip. And it has really good quality. It's definitely not Kayak, and I fucking love... Is Kayak made by U.S. Smokeless? I don't think so.
I have no idea.
I don't think Kayak is made by U.S. Smokeless. I like some of the Kayak. Like, Kayak Grape is good every now and then.
I'm sorry, peoples. I don't like Kayak. I don't like that cack.
But I just can't do the Copenhagen anymore, knowing that one day we could get an email stating that we need to remove these videos that we have worked so hard to put up for you guys, and we don't have copies of these videos. We make them, we put them up, we get rid of them off of our phones, off of our cameras, off of whatever we put it up there with. And it's kind of fucked up, because we grow a lot in these videos, and we've grown so much throughout the videos,
yeah.
Him, me, and I, it's like taking away a kid from someone. You watch that kid grow from being a newborn to being 5 years old and running around playing with other kids, and then you say, oh, well, we're taking that from you. You're taking away the memories.
Yeah, see, that's what, for us, and for most YouTubers, to go back and watch some of their old videos and stuff like that, that's really, like, cringy and weird. Like, we look back and say, that was very, very weird that, you know, we did that stuff, or that's how we started out, to now, to where we can actually communicate better. Most of the time, we're not actually interrupting each other. We talk about, you know, how, what we want to talk about, how we're going to talk about it, who's saying what about
whatever it is that we're talking
about.
Yeah. We take turns. And we've come to understand there's a mutual understanding between the two of us. Because there's not a lot of dip-tubers that have two people on there all the time.
Yeah.
And we have that mutual understanding, that friendship, to where if he's talking, I know that it's not, he's not going to take it the whole time. And I'm not going to take it the whole time. We both get our own time.
Yeah. But for us, these videos actually matter to us. We care about our videos that we make. It is memories, good times, laughter, you know, for other people, so on and so forth. You know, the more people that subscribe and watch the videos, it, you know, it helps us out too, lets us know, hey, people actually like us. People think we're funny, you know, maybe we're actually doing something good. Instead of just sitting on our asses, just, you know, on our free time, whatever, not doing anything. We can come together, join us YouTube partners, and just talk to you guys.
Yeah. And like you said, there's been good memories, there's been fun times, there has been bad memories, and I separate those because the bad memories is like whenever we did the Tide Pod Challenge.
That was fucked up. Oh, and the vanilla, the Grinds coffee pouch vanilla, that one was pretty fucked up. I regretted that one, but it was still kind of funny.
All the videos that came out for the Tide Pod Challenge was a pain in our ass. We stayed up for, what, 12 hours trying to get those videos prepared?
Yeah, dude, we were nonstop talking, yapping, you know, how are we going to do this? How are we going to do that? We kept on messing up, you know, just trying to arrange shit to where it actually made sense and, you know, put stuff in order on how we want to do it to better ourselves and better the video.
We had three missed videos for vanilla.
Mm-hmm.
We had two missed videos for pumpkin spice.
Yeah.
One for, what was the blue one? Cinnamon roll.
Yeah.
And then with the Tide Pod one, we had to remake that video like 5 times.
Yeah, that was 4 videos in one day within just a few hours.
And the caffeine was killing us, but it was fun overall, but at the time we were so irritated,
yeah.
We wanted to give up, but we did it for you, and for the fact that we get to look back on that and think, hey, we were dumbasses, but it worked, and it looked good, and we went through hell to make it happen. And in all of this, though, my main point is that I think it's very disrespectful of U.S. Smokeless to do this, because they want to go and they want to make cans that are camo, and they want to make cans that represent America, and that says U.S. Smokeless, but they want to take away our rights as a form of the press. We judge the flavor, the taste. We review all of their dip. We think that it's good. We try it. We tell you guys, hey, I think this is good. You can try it if you want to. We give them the free gesture. We give them a hand and show everyone what new is coming out, and we try it. And then they want to turn around and take that right from us to be a form of the press and freedom of the press. It's one of our amendments in the Bill of Rights. Basically, what it is that we can review, ask questions, and do things because it's our opinion. You don't have to follow our opinion. U.S. Smokeless doesn't have to follow our opinion. They're a bigger company picking on the little man.
They're doing this shit to small YouTubers, too. People, you know, that have less than 100 subscribers. I mean, why fuck with them? They're just getting started. They haven't done much. Or maybe, you know, their channel itself is old, but they don't record very often, don't have many videos, but still, they're, you know, I'm fucking them over and deleting their videos.
If I were to sit here and slander U.S. Smokeless all day, or if I were to sit here and say that U.S. Smokeless has caused me bodily harm, or I should be part of U.S. Smokeless since I contribute to their money that they make by buying their products, then I can understand that, because then I'm trying to take their business and I'm labeling it as mine. Or I'm trying to force the opinion on you guys that it is fucked up, or that it's amazing. I can understand to a certain extent. Now, I get it. Children watch YouTube, and they see us dipping, and they're like, oh, well, I want to fucking try that. Well, that's their fucking opinion. If they want to try it, let them try it. We all make mistakes, and we all try new things. You grow up, and you get told, how do you know you won't like it unless you try it? And then they go to try it, and then they get yelled at.
Yeah.
Well, I do not buy chew for minors. I do not support that. But if a minor chews, it is on them. If they support their habit, that is on them, because they pay for it.
Yeah, which, me, you know, when, like, I was underage and couldn't buy my own dip and all this shit, yes, I did have other people buy it for me. I mean, how else could I get it? You know, I didn't have much facial hair anyway, so I couldn't, you know, lie, go to a smoke shop or whatever and tell them my birthday and shit like that, like some people do, and get away with it. But I use my money, my hard-earned money, to still pay for it. Just somebody else, you know, go get it.
And, you know, I've had a beard since I was 11 years old. I can walk anywhere I want and buy anything I want.
Except for right now, you know.
Yeah, I'm clean shaven right now. But I can still go in and get me a can of dip and not get carded, because of the simple fact that even though I don't have a beard right now, it's pretty obvious that I'm of age. Because I walk in with, one, a big chewing, and two, I don't waste time in there. I want my fucking dip. Give it to me. I'm out of there.
Yeah,
thank you.
One,
have a nice day.
One of the things, if you try to go in there underage, I guess I shouldn't really be saying this, don't stutter. Walk up to the counter. If you want a can of dip, you say, hey, I want a can. Can I get a can of Copenhagen Winter Drink, please? You know, sometimes...
When I was underage, I never said please.
No, well, you know, you can still be nice about it. You don't have to say please, but... So that kind of helps you out instead of saying, can I get a can of Copenhagen Winter Green? You know, stuff like that. Like, sitting there thinking about it. You got to just be like, on the spot, can of Copenhagen Winter Green. Or whatever dip, you know, you're trying to get. Then you might actually get away with it. I'm not really promoting the fact to... try and buy a dip underage, because, you know, it's illegal and you can still get in trouble. I'm just saying, you know.
But I think that this is the close run of this video. We'll be putting up another video. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. If you have anything to put in on this input, let us know.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, guys. Hope you enjoy the video. This has been Coke Life.
The only life.
We'll see you on the next one, you sassy bastards.